Hello everyone, welcome to the TSS. Let's discuss about some application routine tasks that are required to make your application live, that is available to the web page. Okay, now so after creating your application with Django admin start app and the app name command, so what will happen? Basic application file structure will be created in main project folder, right? So this will be happened if you give this command at the command prompt. Okay, now after that we need to do some tasks to make your application live. So what we need to do, let us discuss step by step. It's very important, friends. So you required to do all these steps to make an application live. Every time you create a new application, you need to do all these things. Okay, now register the application name in settings.py file in the variable called installed_apps. So the first thing you need to do after creating your application is you need to register that application name in the settings.py file. In the settings.py file we have one variable called installed apps. Okay, let me take you to that settings.py file. Let me show up the VS Code editor now. Okay, this is our project folder and it is our project subfolder in which we are having init.py file, settings.py file, url.py file, wsgi file. Okay, and after that we had created the student's application. Okay, in which we are having these 7 items are there. Now after creating this student's application with the command Django admin start app students, the basic application file structure was created by Django. Okay, after that you need to do the routine task to make the student's application live. Okay, the first step is you need to tell to the Django, oh Django, I had created one application called students. Okay, you need to recognize this application, okay, as a part of your web project. So that thing how we have to tell means you need to go to settings.py file. Okay, just click it, it was opened now. So the settings.py file, as the name itself indicates, that total project settings will be available in the settings.py file, friends. Okay, now what we had discussed here, register the application name in settings.py file in the variable called installed apps. Okay, we need to find variable called installed apps. Let us slowly drag down. So base_dir, it is one variable. Okay, so this functionality we will discuss later. Like that, some variable called security key is there, debug is there, allowed hosts variable is there. Here it is installed apps variable is there. In this variable you need to add your application name. What is our application name? Students. Okay, here you can see this one admin authentication, content types, session, messages, static files. Already these applications are available by default. We didn't created with those applications with this command, right? Django admin start app students, like that we didn't do. We did this one. This was already available when we install the Django itself. okay, inbuilt applications, admin application, authentication application, content types application, sessions applications, messages, and starting files. These are called default applications available. Now the user defined application is like this student. So that thing we need to tell to the Django that you please treat this student as an application which I had created newly. So you need to give the name, just a name, that's it, students. So in the form of string, okay. So that is the first step you need to do after creating your application with this command, okay. So what it will do, so if you do like this, if you add your student name, if you add your application name to this installed apps, then Django will understand that, oh okay, some student's application is there, so I need to consider that application and make it a part of the project, okay. Django will do that. You need to just add the name, that's it, okay. So that is the first step. Next, what you need to do is write a view function, business logic for that application in its views.py file. Very important, okay. So registration of application is over. Next, what we need to do is you need to write a view function in its view file, okay. Let's go to the VS Code. Okay, this is our application name. In this application we had view file here, you see view.py, okay, saved it. So in this application, every application has its own views.py file, okay. So just open it. After opening we had this code. Okay, you need to write your view function here. Now from the Python advanced tutorials, I think I had discussed these statements, how to import the packages to the workspace we are currently working, right? So you need the knowledge of Python advanced, not a core Python, advanced Python you need to understand the Django framework, okay. So basic frame Python is it's for scripting purposes, it's okay, but when you go on designing your websites with the Django or Flask or something like web frameworks, then you need to understand the Python advanced concepts. So, mostly whoops, okay, whoop concepts will be there, right? So that concepts you need to understand clearly to understand all these codes. Otherwise all these codes will make you confused, okay. Okay, so how to import a required library or required file or required function or required class to current workspace, okay. So we need to give the command like this, from so and so import so and so. So from means from this file you need to import the render function like that, okay. So this is defaultly available. Now I'm not going to explain all this these codes, rather I just concentrate on the business logic because this is only an starting class. Just I am going to concentrate on the business logic and then we will detailedly discuss about it. Now we'll add some code from Django. We need this http. The beauty of the whoops is, or in the Python is, the whoop methodology of programming is, we can use already prototyped code. We don't need to sit down and all those things again. We don't need to reinvent the wheel. Wheel is already invented. You just use that wheel, invented wheel. Like that, all the codes are prototyped and made available as a packages in the Django. Just from your side, what you need is to know that for particular functionality, particular class is available, function is available. That's it. Then what you do, first knowing that a class or function is available for particular functionality. Okay, then what? The second step, you need to import that code into your workspace and you can use that code. That's it. These two things from your side you should do. Okay, the prototype, all those developments are already done by Django. Okay, so here we are importing the necessary code from Django to this workspace, that is called view.py. From Django.http import http response. Okay, here our IDE is helping us. What are all the classes are available in this particular package? Okay, so for this support, you please go to the extension part and type Django it is not showing up here as of now. Cannot connect to extension mark. Okay, some internet problem is there. Okay, now so if you type this thing, so many extensions will come here, friends. At present it is not coming. Maybe my internet connection has gone. Okay, if you do like this, so many extensions are available. You click one extension called Django IntelliSense. Okay, select that one and install that one. Then if you type like this, that IntelliSense will guide you what are all the syntax, what should be the classes, like that. Okay, now I need this one, HTTP response. So it's beautifully showing up the little bit description about this HTTP response class here. Class HTTP response, what it will do? An HTTP response class with a string as a content. This content can be read, appended to, or replaced. Okay, so that means what means? So it will return the response, the content as HTTP response to the browser. Okay, so this should you remember. Just for specific functionality, there is some class, we need to use that class. In order to use, you need to import that class to the present workspace. That is step number one. And step number two is, you can use that code. Okay, now we need to define one function called, say, index. Okay, the name of the function, view function, is index, friends. Right, and in the parenthesis you should give request. That means, what is the functionality of view function? So it will take the request and it will process the request and it will, at the final stage, it will return the response. So the input is request. From where the request is coming? From the browser. From the browser, request will come and the request will be received to by the view function. And the business logic, the business process will be done here. At the last, we need to return a response. Okay, okay. Now, just I am returning, since it's a basic class, I am returning simple HTTP response of say, hello, I am home page. Sorry, typo. home page. Okay, so this is the response which will be sent to the browser. Okay, I am saving it. So I am explaining, friends, just I had imported the HTTP response class because I need it to provide response to the browser. Okay, and I defined the one function. This is called a view function. So def index, and as a parameter I had given the request. So the request means what? The request is the parameter which is coming from the browser. Okay, the browser request will come to this. Okay, after receiving the request, it will do its own processing and then it will return the output, right? So in this I did nothing because there is no processing, just only returning is there, because this is a basic class. I am not going to define the business logic here. Okay, just I am receiving the request from the browser and returning the response, that's it. Okay, hello, I am home page. So this response will be given to the web browser. Now, so where we are, I think I had explained a lot about view function. So first step we did, second step, write a view function. Okay, this view function is also we did now. Then what we should do? After developing a view function, we need to add the desired web path, that means web page address, and the name of its application view function to URL patterns variable in urls.py file. Friends, at first these are all will look like disturbing, confusing, like that, but it's all very easy once you practice. All these things are very, very easy, friends. Okay, so in the first time itself it looked like some new thing. Not only Django, if you do Laravel, or if you do Spring Boot, or if you do what it is, Express.js, all things will appear like an evils. Okay, big evils, big ghosts, when we first handling it. So if you handle it, then we will become ghosts, then the application will fear to be handled by us. Okay, so that is the just it's a mind game, friends. Okay, mind will not accept anything at the first time, so it is a tough time. It will go tough when it becomes first time. Okay, now anyway, that's an aside topic, so let's do it. So we had did the step 1, step 2, step 3. Now we need to do this fourth step. What this step? Just the step, in one word, if you want me to tell, just connect this view function to the web URL, that's it. Okay, so in order to execute this view function which has defined here, you need to connect this view function, or you need to route this view function to a web address. Okay, if you open this one and if you type so and so, so what is that? We have our web address is like this, because we are in the development, we are using the development server and we didn't bind any domain name. Okay, so that's why our website name is like this. Okay, so after this we need to give the path. Okay, or path, or if you give like this, then it will go to the web server and it will requests the Django about the home page, and then home page will come. How it will come? It will come and it will search in the urls.py file. Okay, now let me show, because you need to connect that view function to the web page, so that will be handled by urls.py file. So let me open the url.py file here. So urls.py file will be available in the project subfolder. So urls.py, what is the function of this urls.py file? So it consists of mappings, friends. Okay, whatever word you may use, the meaning is same. You may call it as mappings or routings or path, all those are synonymous. So this urls.py consists of routes or maps that will direct the request to its corresponding view function. Okay, now the view function is defined here. Okay, here it is. Now you if you type the web page address, then the target is this view function should execute. That is the bottom line. So in order to bring up this functionality, what we should do is you should simply open the urls.py and add the path in the URL patterns. So in the theory part, I had stated it, URL patterns variable. So this is important. URLs patterns variable is there. You need to add an path to that. So this admin path is already there. We didn't create it. It is already available by default. So we need to add path. Simply just I had given just an empty, because I had made it an home page, friends. Okay, for home page we didn't give any thing like products. Okay, products are something like students or something like any pattern we doesn't give, because for home it just comes, and if there is no characters are available, and it will simply go and execute the index function. Okay, if this is the an empty, after what it means is, okay, if it is any empty space after this website address, then you please go and execute the view function. Okay, so this path is a function which consists of two parameters, right? So this first parameter is the path, I mean the web page address, and the next after the comma you need to provide its view function, right? Now the path we had did is we had configured a simple nothing. Okay, so that means we didn't give anything. So if you didn't give anything after this number, what view function should be executed? That is the case now. So our requirement is what? This function should be executed. Okay, def index request this function, this little bit of two quotes, that's it. So in order to execute this function, where this function is located? This function is located in the views.py file. So the views.py file, where this views.py file is located? Inside the folder called students. Okay, now we need to give the view function here. Like how to give? We need to import this view function to urls.py, because this is a file which is available in separate folder, and we need to bring this functionality or code to the urls.py workspace. So how to do it? Simply from where? Students folder, import views. Simple. Okay, from students, that means this is the folder application folder. in which we are having views.py file. Okay, so for that, for bringing these views to the URL workspace, what we need to do is from students import views. This little bit command will take this views code, all the code into this workspace virtually. So after that, we can define here that views dot index. Okay, that means what? In the views, I am defined a function called index. So you go and execute the body of the function, right? So that is the meaning. Okay, so this is the bottom line, friends. So I am making a wrap up. So first create an application and then register the name of the application in installed apps, and then write a view function. Okay, after writing the view function, you need to connect this view function to a particular web page. That web page address will be your wish. Okay, you can name that with any name you want. Okay, I didn't give any name, I simply leave it. So after that, what we should do, we should open the url.py file, and in the url patterns variable, we need to, in the url patterns variable, you need to add path. Okay, this path means the name itself indicates, so it will show the path to that request coming from the web address to the view function. Okay, the path is what? Simple, no, there is no path defined. So if you doesn't, if you doesn't give any name after this number, then it should come and execute views.index. So what is views.index means here. So here views, where it was located, in the students. Okay, it will go to the students and open the view file. Okay, and in the view file, where the index is located, here. So it will simply execute this body. So this much of functionality is taken care of by Django. Okay, friends. So this is easy, right? URLs. Okay, now what will happen? The request will come from the web browser and it will check the URL. From step by step we will understand. So if you open the web browser and request the site like this, and if you press enter, after pressing the enter button here, what steps will be happen behind the screen, you know, just follow. So first it will come here, urls.py. It will check the pattern. Okay, empty pattern is there. Okay, empty pattern is there. So if there is an empty pattern, what should the view function we have to execute? So views.index. Which views.index? The file is located in students app. So go to the students and open the views. Okay, and in the views, there is the function name called index. You need to execute the function index function. So in which we had written only one line called return HTTP response, hello, I am home page. So it will return it. So what should be the output? Hello, I am the home page will be returned to the web page as a response, right? Now let us check it. So after that, what we need to open? So one first step we did, second step we did, third step we did, fourth step we did, fifth step, open the web browser and type the configured web path. That means in our case we didn't configure any path, it's just we had left it empty in the address bar, and it should display output of view function data to the browser screen, right? So let us do it, friends. Opened here, I have typed the website address and I am pressing enter. Now It doesn't come. Why it doesn't come? Just we doesn't made the development server up. So to make the development server up, what which command we should give? Python manage.py run server. Okay. So we need to make the server live, friends. Okay. Here I had pressed the enter. Now system check identified, no issues. Okay, no issues, zero silenced. So all these things I had explained earlier. Starting development server at this. Okay, you need to open this thing. Okay, so now server is running. Now you can go to the web browser. Wow, it was appeared. Okay, if it is not, I am once again I will type it manually. 18000. Okay, after 8000 I am not giving anything. Okay, so I am clicking enter. You can see, wow, congratulations, we had designed a web page. Okay, first web page, that is user defined web page. In the earlier classes the default web page come, here it is our user defined web page. So this is the home page, friends. This is your site name, this is your home page. Okay, so let me make it somewhat big so that you people can see. So in the HTTP response itself I will append one h1 tag. Okay, h1. So this is an HTML language, so it will go as an response to the browser. In the response to the browser, what browser will do is it will decode the string which was given here. So at the time of decoding it will come across this h1. Okay, browser understand that I need to make this bit of a string as a h1 heading, so that it will do its own functionality. Here I am refreshing it. 1 minute. Okay, it is now our server becomes up. Now open here. Okay, every time we had made any modifications to the code, the server automatically restarted, friends. Please note, any modifications to any file in the project will make our development server to reboot automatically. So by itself it will restart, friends. We no need to do it. Okay, right now hello, I am home page, this page comes up. Okay friends, so this is the scenario of the request response cycle. So we open up the browser, we type the site name or .1:8000, and by clicking enter this request has gone to the web server and it contacts the Django framework. And the Django framework, what it will do, the Django framework will search that path in the urls.py file. Okay, so it's empty. Now if it is empty, what function should execute? So that we had represented here, views.index. So where this views.index is located, it was located in the students application. It will go to the students application and then opens the views.py and executes the index function. So in index function, what we had defined, we had simply defined this string, that's it. So it is returned to the browser's screen, that's it. Okay, so that is the bottom line, friends. So if you understand this basic thing, and I think you will half done, friends, in the developing of Django project, you are already done halfway. Okay, next. Now if you want, so here you please observe, I didn't give any path after the website name. Okay, if you want the path called, say, some students like this, okay, like this, then you need to define this path in the URL, okay. So that's why I first take that example, empty example, then so you need to define this here, students, okay, whatever name you need, you need to specify it, path, students. Then if we request the web page like this by typing the website name, this is the website name, after that this is the path. If you give the path like this, then it will come and Django will search in the URLs, okay, students path is available or not, okay, it is available, okay, it is available. Now what function should execute, what view function should execute, okay, it will go and finds this and it will execute this one, okay, or you can name this function as students, no problem. So if you name this function as students, then you should change this here also, views.index place you need to give students, okay, right, here also we have to save. So all are saved. Now if you open, so you see this development server is automatically restarted. Now I am opening a new page and I am typing the URL, and now if you give like this, it won't come because this request goes to the Django and the Django checks in the urls.py file. Now there is no empty path configured in the URL patterns. So that's why it doesn't find the path. If the Django doesn't find the path, simply it will display this page, this error, page not found, 404. What? Using URL config defined in mywebsite.urls file. So how many paths are defined? Admin and students. That means only these two paths are there. Okay, this empty path is not there. So that's why error is coming. So these pages will come, nice exceptions are coming, friends. So the reason is we had made the debug is equal to true in the Django settings file. So it is okay in the development environments, but it is not advised to make debug is equal to true in production environment, friends. Okay. Now what you should do is you can give like this students. Okay, students. So if you type this path, now you can see hello, I am home page. Okay, this is all about the connecting the view functions to appropriate web path. So this is called web path. This web path should be connected to appropriate corresponding view function. So now this is the web path, students, which we are giving by opening here, okay, students. And what it should do, it will go and execute the views function. So what view function? So it is in the students, open the view function and it will execute the name students function. Or if it is like confusion, you can make hello, you can do like that also, no problem. If you are little bit, it is confusing because app name is also students and function name is also students, okay. View dot hello, same, okay. So if you give this path, it will open this view, particular view file, and it will execute the hello function which was available in the view file, okay. So let me execute again for you, okay, slash students here. Now the page is coming, right, okay, friends. This is all about the application routine tasks, okay. These five steps you need to do. So if you are not able to see any data of view function output to the screen, then you need to go back and verify these 5 steps, okay, whether you are doing anything wrong in these 5 steps, okay. So this is the note I had placed here, okay friends. Okay, in the next session we will discuss about templates, friends, okay. So the templates, because in our this class we had just mentioned a simple line, but so for this simple line it is okay, but if you want to design a page, so here it is only one line. If you want to design whole web page, okay, then you need to do lot of HTML code. So if you have lot of HTML code, so we can't put that much HTML code inside this HTTP response, okay. So it will become cumbersome, okay, so ugly. So that's why we will create templates folder, and in that templates we will create HTML files, friends, okay, and then we will use this render function. Now we had used HTTP response class or function here. So after creating the HTML templates folder, we'll use this render to return the response as a HTML document, not as a format of string, in the format of strings, okay. Okay friends, in the next class we'll do that. Till then, bye bye. Your Svira signing off. Thank you for listening.